Was quick. Join right in. Hey, good evening, everybody. Good evening. Hello, everyone. Let's see. Let's get this all cameraed in.
The light is bad.
Linda, let me just adjust it. Hey, guys, let's fix the light. We're going to have to get cozy. There we go. That's good. There we go. Hey, guys. Hey.
The light's too bright in my eyes.
Okie doke. So start talking.
I don't know. I'm not, it's not my job to talk.
How's that? Okay, how's the light? How's the light? Hey, everybody, it's Jeff of Solid Canine Training. How are you? Thank you for joining tonight. What would Jeff do every Monday and Wednesday at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time? I did miss this past Monday. I'm at a seminar out in Ellington, Florida, and it's a 45-minute drive back here, 45-minute back to the seminar, so I decided, unfortunately, I couldn't do it, plus I was in the middle of the seminar. So we're going to get caught up tonight. So we've got 1 hour. We've got 1 hour and 5 minutes. We've got 1 hour of asking me all your dog training questions. My name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. What you can do is there's a little character in the corner here. Click on that character. Share this on Facebook. Share this on Twitter. And you can also share this on Periscope. You also want to sign up for all my different social media. Instagram, Snapchat, Snapchat, YouTube, Periscope,
Facebook. How come you look normal and I look...
I don't know what to tell you. I'll tell you what. I'll try to fix it, but you have to talk so we don't have dead air. Okay.
No, don't fix it. It doesn't matter.
So.
It's not about me.
Okay, it is about you. Okay, you have to look fantastic. You look better there. Good. It's also been raining here, no sun. All right. So, thank you. Thank you. She looks fine. All right. So, let's get right to the questions. We're down in Ellington, Florida. We're on our day three of T3. Start a dog crate training. Lays down but whines. Should I correct with the remote already? How old is the dog? Hey, Washington, how are you? How old is the dog? Because if the dog's really young, you don't want to correct with the remote. Dog's 3 years old and you're just starting crate training now. Is that 3 years or 3 months? Three years or three months. Because that's important. Because you don't want to correct dogs for whining at 3 months old on a remote. Actually, probably shouldn't even be using a remote at 12 weeks old. So for 3 years, yes. For the dog is 3 years old and the dog is whining, what I would want you to do is I want you to correct the dog. So you correct the dog for whining. Whining is annoying. It's also the dog's mental state. Think about this, the dog's mental state. Oh, yeah, okay, great. So, yeah, correct her. Yep, correct her. Just teach her the whining is and how do you do that? It could be continuous. It could be one momentary. It could be down low. It could be up high. You know, it's okay. You know, it's okay. One-year-old dog does great at night, no fuss. Is it okay not to crate him at night? Personally, I'm a big advocate of crates. I'm a big advocate of crates. But if you do not want to use a crate, that is fine. You know, pedigree is terrible for your dog. If you do not want to crate your dog, don't crate your dog. I encourage everybody to crate your dog. That's up to you. 1 year old, the dog is not even into adulthood yet. A lot of stuff can be happening. So the crate is a leadership exercise. Dogs love going in the crate. And if they don't, you'll teach them how to love going in the crate. So it's really important that dogs learn how to be in the crate, and you want to crate train your dog because you never know when it's going to need to be in the crate. So I'm a huge advocate of crating dogs, kenneling dogs up. You know, but that's, again, that's personal choice. It's personal choice. I advocate crating. I advocate containment. So, all right, Linda, what do we got?
How did you teach girl to ignore people?
How do I teach girl? Some of that might be just her. That's just how she is. What I just did was a lot of times I just don't let people pet her. So I don't let a lot of people interact with my dogs. So therefore they don't look at other people as anything great. But I can also release her and then she'll interact with somebody. I mean, she loves people, but I just don't want my dogs to be focused on other people. All my dogs are human friendly. But I want my dogs to be sort of focused on me and ignore people. I want my dogs to ignore people. All right, what else?
Dog stops before entering crate and stares. How do I get the dog to go in?
Okay, the way you're crate, I've got a video on kenneling up. So I've got a video on kenneling up. It's kenneling up. I want your dog to go in the kennel on command. And then also when you open the door, I want the dog to wait at the threshold. I do not want your dog to be running out of the crate. So watch my video, but it's going to be done on a leash. So you're going to do leash work. It's all done on leash work. So if the dog just stops, you'll be giving it a little bit of leash pressure. You'll be doing a little bit of leash pressure. All right, what's next?
15-week-old pup screams in his crate in excitement when I open the door to get his food. Is this okay?
It's not okay at all. You will end up with a 16, 17, 18, 19, a 20-week-old, one-year-old dog that just screams. So you need to shut your dog up. So you're training your dog that when it screams, it gets food, screams and gets food. What I would do is this. You open up the crate door, the dog tries to come out of the crate door, you close the crate door really, really quick in the dog's face. You will not hurt the dog, you will not do anything. You don't have to tell the dog to be quiet, anything like that. You need to get that dog to be calm. You need the dog to be calm in the crate. So, or else what you're doing is you're rewarding that dog with freedom and rewarding that dog with food. So I know the dog's excited, that's great that the dog's excited, but it will lead to massive programs. When he opens up the garage door, then he screams, with the garage door, he's screaming with excitement because chances are, how do you come in the house? So how do you come in the house? So if you come in the house all excited, come in the house when he's all excited. So bottom line is shut the dog up. So correct him. So correct him. Whatever the reason your dog is screaming, unless he's been hit by a car, just correct the dog. How do you do that? Leash pop, remote collar stim. Okay, teach the dog how to go into place and to be quiet, right? Throw a bonker at the dog. A bonker is a wrapped up towel. We've talked about bonkers before. Toss it at the dog. You can use a pet convincer. Pet convincer is compressed air, right? I don't do bite work, so I don't know. I don't do bite work, so I don't know how to do that. All right, what else?
Do you have a protocol for a dog that chews severely on crate at night? Dog
yes.
Bends crate in minutes.
Yep, I do. So what I would do is this. Hey, Montreal, what I want you to do is teach your dog how to go into the crate and lie down with the door open. Not at night when you're not there, but you're going to turn that crate into an obedience command. So it's kennel up, down, kennel up, down. Then what I want you to do is you get a dog on the remote collar. The dog even attempts to put its mouth on that crate to get out, whether it's its paw or its mouth or any anxious activity at all, you correct. Okay, your dog will not be forever. We do it all the time. We use the remote collar to stop crate nonsense. Any crate nonsense, you stop with the remote. Okay, you use a good quality remote. We do not recommend a cheap remote. We recommend anything from e-collar technologies or Dogtra. We recommend also Garmin. Those are the ones we recommend, all right? How high do you correct? High enough for the dog to stop the behavior. I do not know, all right? I do not know. Even on the leash, she pulls back and won't enter the crate. Just try repetition, lots and lots of repetition. You might have to actually be a little bit quote unquote forceful. If you wanna use food for the first couple of times, use food for the first couple of times. All right, that's fine, all right? That's fine. Next.
What results should I expect after 5 sessions of in-home training?
All depends on the dog trainer. That's too wide of a question. It all depends on the dog trainer. It all depends on you, and it all depends on the dog's behavior. It all depends on the dog training system. Way too many variables. There's way too many variables. All right? Way too many variables. All right?
What's a good age to start a puppy on a remote?
We start dogs on remote for 14 weeks. 14 weeks old, but we do it with food. It's paired with food. It's very specific on how we do it. The remote is just in the background. It's just like this. So just like this. That's all it does. So I don't have, it's not my training system. So again, it all depends on you and the trainer. You and the trainer and how much work you do. Remember, it's not about us and the work or the knowledge we have. It's about the client and the dog working together as a team. It is a partnership. It is a partnership. I do not care how good I am or my trainers are. If the client is not invested with massive amounts of time, energy, and practice, the dog will not make the progress that it's supposed to. There's way too many variables. There's way too many variables. There's just way too many variables, you know? So, all right.
My dog is good at healing in the front of the house sidewalk, but not in other places.
So what's happening is your dog is just distracted. Your dog is distracted. What I want you to do is I want you to work on remote collar healing, Also work on focus work. Also make sure you're using the proper tools. So remote collar, prong collar for healing. What's happening is the dog gets distracted and then all of a sudden it goes bonkers most likely, or it's pulls, or it is like looking all over the place. So remote collar heel. The cool thing is your dog does know how to walk in front of the house, which is great. All right. Cool. There's a bunch of questions we missed. New foster gets aggressive, barks, lunges.
Yeah,
okay, cool.
So moving to e-collar recall correction only phase, can you explain how that phase works?
You always do it on a leash. So if your dog recalls all the time, right, without using the remote, and then it decides to blow you off, what I want to do is that dog should be on a long line. You would correct high at a correction level. So what's high? I don't know. If say you're working at 10, it could be 25. So you would call your dog to you. If it doesn't listen, you would give your dog a quick pop of the remote, have a leash on the dog. The dog, if it's properly trained, should just turn around and come running back to you. Right? So
Yorkie bites when being picked up. Bonker makes it worse.
A bonker or the honker?
Oh, honker, sorry.
Honker, what's a honker? Because I saw that question too. If that's an air horn, the Yorkie bites, I would check for physical injuries. All right, so what I would do with physical injuries is check its mouth, check its ears, check its spine, make sure that it's back. You can either go to a chiropractor for that or go to a doctor for that.
Bonked.
Bonked with a bonker, okay. So what I would do is check for that. Also, if the dog is being picked up, if it's biting you, what I would do is I would actually take a welding glove, and I would take the welding glove and I would just stick the welding glove right in the dog's mouth. Let it bite it. Go ahead, bite. Go ahead. And don't take it out until it calms down.
Oh, it says the bonker does work.
Oh, cool. All right. We're confused.
That's not what I wrote down, but.
Your dog barks in his crate when you're away. Bark collar. A bark collar shuts up dogs when you are not home. I do not know another way to do it. I don't care how much you exercise your dog. It's all based on getting your dog calm. If it's barking in the crate or barking in the yard or barking in the house when you are not home, you should get a bark collar for your dog. They're under $100 and they work. Do not get don't get the air ones. Don't get the citronella ones. Get the stim ones. All right. What brand? You can use Garmin Bark Limiter or eCollar Technologies. They make an eCollar technology, eCollar.com. You can do those two we recommend. Unfortunately, there's not one great bark collar on the market. The pet corrector, we use pet correctors all the time. All right.
Okay. 4-month-old dog growls and bites. Should I use a remote collar?
4-month-old dog growls and bites at 4 months old, not to stop that. So what I would do is I would find out what the heck is going on. What are the protocols? What's your training routine? How much structure is in your dog life? Before I would even use a remote collar to correct a growling, biting dog at 16 weeks old, I want that dog crated at night, crated when you're not at home. I want that dog in place. I want that dog to have no free roaming. That dog could be on a food training protocol where it has to wait for its food. I want that dog to know the out command. I want that dog to be able to know sit down place before you do any of that stuff. I don't want that dog on any furniture. I don't want that dog in your bed at all. I want affection cut in half. I want to have all the place should be structured. All high-pitched voices get lowered, all right? Get lowered, all right?
How to stop dog from breaking out of crates? He won't do it when we're home, only when we leave.
So you're gonna need a really, really strong crate. You're gonna have to use zip ties, and you're also gonna have to probably use carabiners to secure it. Also, what you're gonna have to do is teach your dog, I already talked about this at the beginning of the show, teach your dog how to be calm in the crate. So also, what remote collar then? You have to remote collar. Set the dog up, look through a window, the dog tries to break out of the crate, correct it. Bottom line is this. If you want to stop your dog from doing a bad or dangerous behavior, you have to make it suck. That's just the way it is. So that's how you have to do it. All right? Next.
Dog consistently stops at same location immediately before going for a walk. Why does this happen?
Why does it happen? Because you let the dog. You let the dog do it. That's why. The dog trained you to stop. There's probably a smell there. There's probably an odor or a smell. It could be from anything. It could be another dog. It could be a cat. It could be from anything, right?
I got a call from a client with an aggressive GSD who bites and attacks people. I turned
Good.
It down.
Gabe, okay. You should not be working with aggressive dogs. You do not have enough experience working with dogs yet. You should absolutely not be working with aggressive dogs, and I'll tell you why. You will get injured. You possibly might not be able to help the client, and the client might put the dog down because they felt like they actually tried to fix the dog. What you need to do, Gabe, is you need to find a local trainer that works with aggressive dogs to refer out to. That's what you need to do. That's what you need to do. People that don't have, if you've not worked with a couple of hundred dogs yet, you probably shouldn't be working with aggressive dogs. Aggression is a whole other world. And an aggressive German Shepherd, a human aggressive German Shepherd, you most likely should not be touching right now. You need a lot of experience. You should be doing heavy behavior mod and know how to work with these dogs. All right, and I would say, and I would suggest not working with a client aggressive dog first. I would suggest working with somebody like from a shelter or a rescue and see what you can do. All right, so test out your skills with a dog that does not belong to somebody. Yes, you can. Yep, Jillian, yep, you use the prong collar and the e-collar at the same time. We do something called remote collar healing, where it's like clutching gas, and then the prong collar will end up just being just in case because the dog lunges. Because prong collar, I mean, remote collars are not directional. They're not directional. Right, what else?
New foster gets aggressive, barks, growls, lunges when someone knocks or rings doorbell.
Okay, this is really, really easy. In fact, I was talking about this today at T3. Let's just understand this concept. If you have a dog, anybody out there that has the dog, this is going to be a really simple fix. Anybody out there that has a dog that rushes the door when somebody walks by, the doorbell rings, somebody knocks at the door, or somebody comes in my opinion, the best way to stop this is to make that behavior suck. Think about that. What does suck mean? Uncomfortable. What does uncomfortable mean? Discomfort physically. Yes, that's what I am saying. I have absolutely no problem for somebody saying pain. Yes, you inflict 1 to 2 seconds of discomfort to your dog for doing a dangerous behavior. It is a very dangerous behavior. So nobody's having these conversations. There's very few of us that are having these conversations publicly. But I am sorry, if any of my dogs ever rush the front door, barking, growling, jumping, I would make it suck for 3 seconds and they would never do it again. And we would never have a problem again. Think about that. But this concept of when they don't do it, reward and praise them, I'm sorry, it does not work. It might work right now, but what happens when it doesn't work? You have to be prepared to create discomfort. I am not this hardcore, heavy-handed dog trainer at all. If anybody has actually ever seen me work with dogs, I don't talk to dogs. I am gentle. I am almost like a ballet working with dogs. But when it comes to certain behaviors, I will be unemotional. I'm not mad at you. I'm not angry at you. I do not hate you. But I highly dislike that behavior, and I will let you know in a very calm way from me that that decision you made was the wrong decision, and I do not want you to do it again. And more people need to do this. More people need to do this. Okay? That's just the way it is. Okay? Do not struggle with this. Nobody should be struggling with this for more than a week. Level 100, if that's what it takes. But it shouldn't be at a level of 100. That's not an act of God. That could be at a 50 or a 60. I don't know. But all I know is, when should you say no when correcting? You could, but I would just rather make it suck. But you can say no, and then boom. That's it. You're not mad. Do not yell. Do not scream. Do not freak out. Just calmly say N-O, boop, with a remote. And people can give me a hard time. I really don't care. I could care less. But people are getting rid of their dogs. So my dog jumps all over the place and makes it hard for me to put on his collar or prong collar. Okay, well, you want to do a prong collar, you want to do a collar counter conditioning protocol. I want you to look up a video. The dog's name is Rupert. It's on my YouTube channel underneath behavior modification playlist. Rupert, collar conditioning. That's what you are going to do. That's what you're going to do, all right? Your dog doesn't do anything until it gets that collar on, but it is a training protocol. Your dog is playing a game with you, and the dog is winning. the dog's having the best time of his life or her life. All right.
When pulling back affection for disciplining, when is it most beneficial to bring affection back?
You can bring, all depends on what you're disciplining the dog. I don't withhold affection to discipline. I with beginning of the dog has earned it. Dog has earned it. All right. So think about that. My canine training. I'm a very balanced dog trainer. They're killing it over there. They're doing a great job. We do boarding trains, one-on-ones. We do aggression rehab, behavior modification too. 1,000 videos. I do huge amounts of pro bono work. Cool character in this corner. Click on that. Share this on Facebook. Share this on Twitter. And I travel the world doing seminars. But I tell it like it is. I do conversation because I'm sick and tired of 5 million dogs a year in the United States being killed. Simple things. Dog reactive dog, prong collar dog would never. I want your dog to be calm. I want your dog to be calm when it walks by the dogs. So beginning, create more space. Create space, and I would switch to remote collar healing. Create space, right? And as soon as that dog starts getting like, so everybody watch my head, ready? That's calm, right? See that? That's when you would use the right. You don't need to be fully. There are companies out there that actually go right to remote collar training. Right to remote collar training. Yep. So you don't have to have a leash trained dog remote collar. Should be Rupert with a P. It was a misspelling. Try Rupert. I'm pretty sure Rupert's in the title. Pretty sure Rupert's are in the titles. And I've been trying to be able to do one of these here, and I will try to do it this week while I'm here at the T3. I might have to do it after hours. All right?
In the dog's daily food for training, do you limit to their daily amount or use what you need?
Great question. What I want you to do, Eve, are you brand new, Eve? Welcome. I haven't seen you before. Welcome to my world. What I want you to do is this. Take the dog's daily food amount, put it in a bowl, put it on top of the dog's counter, and then use food to monitor it, because it is a humongous problem, at least in the U.S., with dogs. To me, having a fat dog, oh, you're Coralie, I love you. Oh my gosh, you're great, you're awesome. I recognize, all I see is some picture, and then I see behind him, right?
Barked when corrected with.
So all you're doing is, that's what your dog said to you. You said place, and then the dog probably didn't do it, and you said no, and the dog says F you. So this is what I want you to do. Your nose at 15 weeks old should be just informational only. Your nose at 15 weeks old should be only informational. It should not be no. It should just be no. So your dog should have a leash on, and you do place, and then you bring your dog over to play, breaks it, say no, and bring your dog back on a leash. Should not be your dog for obedience if sold. And that makes sense. So it's not like the dog jumped up on a counter or tried to get out of its crate. It's just no. All obedience commands, we don't correct at that age at all. We don't correct probably up until almost 6 months with anything more than just informational no. Yep, you're too harsh, yeah. So EE, what I want you to do is, listen, you have a 15-week-old dog. You're probably a little bit frustrated. I get it, right? When you're frustrated, Guthrie, what I want you to do is take a chill pill and stop working with your dog, because you're not helping the dog, and you're not helping you at all, and it's just, but it's frustrating. It's frustrating training a puppy. I get it. So just be like, no, that's it. What's next?
Dog is bad while meeting other dogs on or off leash.
Okay, you're welcome, buddy, I love you. Your dog should never, ever, ever, ever meet a dog on a leash. I will stick to that till the day I die. Now, when we introduce dogs, We have a dog on a leash, but we do it in a very specific protocol, and all the other dogs are off leash. I've got videos on how we introduce a dog to a pack. That's a different thing than what I'm talking about. But when you've got two dogs on leash, and there might be a little bit of tension at the leash, they're gonna fight. They're gonna fight. So I don't want you to do that off leash. That's a different protocol. And I've got videos on how to introduce dogs to other dogs. But if your dog has any aggression or the other dog does, I don't recommend people doing that by themselves. Right, that's something that we do, and I've got videos on that. What I suggest you find is a very structured socialization group by you that can help you. All right, that's what I would suggest. Some stuff is not like doesn't scale to Periscope, but we do it. So everything I recommend, we do. Some things are would be a little bit unethical if I ask you to do them at home on your own, because there could be like, you know, your dog can end up in a dog fight, and I don't want anybody's dog ending up in a dog fight, and I don't want anybody to get bit.
Could a pet convince or teach a dog to be afraid of loud noises or sudden bursts of noise?
I guess it could happen. I've never seen it. I guess it could happen, but I've never seen it. Remember, if you correct a dog in a timely, calm way, your dog will be fine. Your dog will be fine. But if you use a pet convincer in a group of dogs, yes. Yes, I've absolutely seen something. Oh my God, what did I do? And in the towards that noise, the noise makes it. Please do not curse unless the dog park is like 10 acres or more. You shouldn't be going to a dog park. Your average dog park is filled with untrained dogs, uneducated owners, dogs that can be sick or have disease. You've got all kinds of things from giardia to worms to everything, So what I would do is I would stay out of dog parks. I don't like dog parks. A lot of bad behaviors are encouraged at dog parks, are reinforced at dog parks. Dog fights could happen. People don't know how to break up a dog fight. Everybody thinks their dog is perfect, but they're far from perfect. I would never, ever, ever take my dog to a dog park, ever. Most good trainers will never, you will rarely ever see a good trainer at a dog park. You just won't. You just won't. Next.
Dog is good one-on-one with another dog. If there are two dogs playing, she charges and starts a fight.
So your dog, she should not be off leash, and your dog is trying to be the sheriff. Unfortunately, your dog is not able to be off leash with other dogs right now, but that would be a corrective thing to do. So it's your responsibility to keep your dog away from those two dogs or any two dogs that does that. Because, I mean, just think about what your dog is doing. It's going to cause harm. It's going to cause harm to another dog, or to your own dog, So what I want you to do is don't let your dog do that. Just don't let your dog do it. So your dog should be back, put back on leash. Your dog should be remote collar trained and have an awesome recall as well, right? Can you pet convince another person's dog? Peter, be careful, but you could. Be super careful. Just be super careful. Right? All it is air, though. All it is air. But just be careful, right? What? Oh, hey guys, my name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Solid Canine Training. Go to my website. And little character in that corner right there, click on that. Share this on Facebook, share this on Twitter. You can also make sure you share this on Periscope. Linda, did anyone ever tell you Da Vinci painting? Is that good?
I don't know. Is that good?
Thank you for the compliment. How's that? All right. Dog parks are great for you to work your reactive dog on the outside. On the outside of. That's different than the inside. That's different than the inside of the dog park. Absolutely. What you should do is you should use all of the chaos of the dog park to train your dog how to be calm around chaos. That's what I would do.
I have a 16-month female poodle. Lately, she goes crazy when someone walks their dog by the house.
Okay. What I would do is don't let your dog do it. So what I would do is to correct your dog for doing it. I would have your dog on a remote collar. I would start limiting the amount of free roaming your dog has in the house. And what do you do when your dog charges the window? Bottom line is this, you make it suck. It's a simple concept that I know a lot of people are afraid to do because nobody obviously wants to hurt their dog. This is the cool thing. I don't want to hurt anybody's dog either, let alone mine. But I'd also don't want to have my dog barking at other people's dogs in my house or out of my house. So what do? I tell it not to. How do I do that? I do that with a remote cower. But let's also remember something, folks. Remote cowers, 90% of the time I use on very low levels, 10% of the time I use on higher levels. When I'm trying to eliminate a behavior, hopefully forever. Could it come back? Of course it could. Let me give you a great, I don't use vibrate at all, and it doesn't shock, it's stim. I don't use vibrate. Use the stim because the stim is adjustable. Vibrate is not, you know, I've rarely seen vibrate work. It might be working for somebody, good for you, that's awesome, but vibrate doesn't go up or down. So I use stim. Why? Because if it doesn't work on a lower level, it enables me to go to a higher level. Do not be afraid to correct your dog in a timely, calm way for behavior that you do not like at all. Do not be afraid to do it. You will not break trust. This is how you break trust in your dog, is not stopping the dog's behavior. That's how you do it.
How long does it take for a dog to learn a command perfectly?
There's no such thing as perfect, in my opinion, so I don't know. Reliably, it all depends on the dog, the human, and the training system, and how much work you put into it. That you know, if anybody had a, you know, an answer, I mean, for I can get a dog to do a perfect sit, if there is such a thing as a perfect sit, in, you know, sometimes less than an hour, even off leash, just use food, right? So I mean, there's a lot of ways to train a dog, but you know what? Please don't be set on perfect. Okay, nobody has a perfect dog. Stim, some people call it shock, but it's stim, meaning it's stimulation, but it does not shock. Shock implies abuse, and dogs are not being abused with remote collars. Okay, and that's another thing, is that I know there's a lot of pressure for a lot of owners out there because of all the nonsense on the internet to ban shock collars, and that's a whole other thing. Let me do a public service announcement right now. I rarely ever do this, but Lush stores, lush.ca and lush.com, okay, I'm sorry, but I will never use your products again because you are backing banshockcowers.ca, and how dare you delve into those waters with information you know nothing about, okay? You know, stick to makeup, all right? If you want to worry about animal testing, go ahead. But dog training, stay out of it. How dare you? How dare you do that? Because the photos that they are using are outright blatant lies. You are being lied to. The general public is being lied to. And I'm sorry, I rarely ever use my show as a soapbox, but I am going to start using my show as a soapbox because people that disparage remote cowers with those fake pictures, those false pictures, those doctored pictures, those outright blatant lies, calling shock cowers abusive, that is wrong. Yes, I love their products too.
Me too.
I will never use them again until there is a public apology. Right? They do not know anything about it. PETA kills 98% of their dogs. PETA is a bunch of a-holes as well. Right? PETA is a money-making scam machine that pays its board of directors huge amounts of money. Do I think that cheap e-cowers, I wouldn't use a PetSafe e-cower. You know? I wouldn't use a PetSafe e-cower. I'm not a big fan of cheap e-cowers. They're inconsistent. Anyway, next question.
Dog shakes head on walks with prong collar. Is that normal?
All right, what does stim do? This is what I'd like you to do, Holden Heights. You're probably
Dude, I just asked you a question.
I know, but let me, Holden Heights keeps asking. I want you to do this, Holden Heights. I want you to go find someone that uses a remote collar from eCower Technologies or Dogtra or Garmin or even Sport Dog, and I want you to feel it. It feels like a tingle. It feels like a TENS unit. Shocking is sticking your finger in an outlet. They absolutely do not shock. I have videos of these on my neck at 100, right? So just keep that in mind. So it's a stimulation. All it is a communication device. That's all it is, all right? Right. So what was the question?
Dog shakes head on walks with prong collar. Is that normal?
You're welcome, Holden Heights. And thank you for asking me in such a very professional way. I appreciate that. It shakes with a prong collar. It probably is just getting used to this, the feeling of it. It's like a small objection. It might be irritating. That's all.
My dog does well now with dogs behind fences, but still reactive with passing dogs on leash.
What I want you to do, the passing dogs on the leash, I want you to work on focus work, and I want you to start creating space. So create space. So if a dog is walking down the same sidewalk as you, I want you to move off the sidewalk, work on focus as you're walking, or work on some drills. You don't have to walk your dog on the same sidewalk. Like, you can actually start incorporating, excuse me, a little bit of space. That was good sushi tonight, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
It was really good sushi. Okay, good, good. All right. You guys want to do a screenshot? Ready, screenshot? Ready? This is the way screenshots work. I'm gonna hold up my Bucky's mug. I'm gonna hold up my Bucky's mug. And then what I'm gonna, you know, what you're gonna do is you're gonna take a photo, and then you're gonna, and then what you're gonna do is you're going to tweet the photo to me. Tweet the photo to me, and then you do that by going to Twitter and then hitting write, or send. You know, write a letter, write a tweet. You put @SolidCanineTraining. You attach the photo, and then you put "I love Bucky's." Ready? Smile. Don't make angry faces.
Thank you.
How to teach your dog to look up at you when, this is Charles. He's a T3.
Oh, hey, Charles.
Yeah.
What's shaking?
So, hey, Steph, how are you? We love you. We love you, Steph.
Oh, hey, Steph.
So, I've got a focus video.
Do you have a focus video?
Yep. All right. Next.
When would you stop using food to proof recall?
Stop using food?
Yes.
I would stop using food to proof recall. I would go to remote collar. I would make sure that dog turns around and, hold on one second. Girl, no, please. Good girl. So I would stop using it when the dog turned on remote collar, like almost 100% of the time. Right? Next.
Dealing with non-dedicated owner,
nothing you can do. You shouldn't work harder than the owner. So wrong client. So you can tell them that, you know, you can tell them, listen, I need you to do your homework, or you have to give them a level of expectation that they're not gonna get the results that they might want, or maybe they are getting the results that they want and they just don't care. So it's not your job to care more about the result of the dog than the owner is. The owner should be working just as hard, if not harder than you, on the dog training. It is their dog. So if they don't care, sorry, I can't care. So the dog drags behind on the walk, I would make sure that the dog is physically okay. Make sure the dog is the dog overweight? Does the dog have breathing issues? And if not, it's just like healing. You know, it's just like, if you pull, I've got to get you next to me. And if you drag, I got to get you next to me. All right, it could be just an objection. How's the mange? The mange is going great. My balls are pristine, right?
That's so gross.
Right.
Dog walking service, could you offer strictly structured walking, i.e. prong collar?
Yeah, I would suggest that if you want to start a dog walking service, you do it the way you want to do it. So you would only take clients that would abide by how you walk the dogs. So if you feel that the best way to walk the dogs is at the remote collar and on the prong collar, then that's how you do it. And if a client doesn't want you to do it, that can't be the client for you. It's your company. You can set the policies. Yep. Road salt hurts the paws. Dogs won't wear booties. You can counter condition the dogs to wear the booties. But what I would do is I would also just clean the dog, wipe the dog's paws off after they're done. They make a couple of kinds of booties. They make the booties that are the almost like big balloons. But then they also make the booty ones that are from rough wear.
My brother just got those for his dog.
Yep.
He has a pit bull, and they're going great.
Yep. Vaseline on paws protects against the salt. Paw wax, awesome. Mm-hmm. Awesome. Yep. She cries during the walks. It's possibly the dog has cracks on the bottom of its feet. So what I would do is I would mush her secret. Thank you, mush her secret. Good. So there's some products out there that do it. Yes, the remote, it's a remote collar. Yes. Yep. It's a remote collar. So, and just remember Holden Heights that 90% of the stuff out there is negative about remote collars, but it's outright false. I use them every day. I've trained thousands of dogs on them. My colleagues use them. I put them on my neck. I've let my children hold on to them. They don't burn a dog. It's impossible. So remember, a remote collar does not burn a dog. If a vet ever says that a remote collar burns a dog, they actually should have their medical license taken away, because what they did was they just lied to you. If a medical professional, which has a code of conduct, lies, I would imagine they should be reprimanded, censored, I don't know all the right words, or possibly to have their medical license taken away. They have outright blatantly lied to you. They've blatantly lied to you. It's no different than the vet saying, if your dog eats out of a stainless steel bowl, your dog will get cancer. All right?
What's this SD one? Have an SD, want to start IPO. I'm told SD shouldn't do dog sports.
Technically, a proper service dog is not supposed to bite, even controlled biting. So your service dog, so legally, according to the ADA in the United States, Americans with Disability Act, in order for a dog to fly in a plane, it's not supposed to have bite training. So a service dog should not have bite training legally. So that would be now a personal choice between you and your dog. So that would be my thing. Okay.
Do you think it's better for a dog to be kenneled instead of chained, even if a dog
absolutely, has a absolutely, a dog should never be chained, in my opinion. Agility, yes, your dog can do agility. But remember, these are my opinions. These are my opinions, but I'm very familiar with the ADA laws because I'm very active with service dog organizations and the fraudulent use of dogs for service dog work. So just be careful. Louisiana, yes, I would look up the good dog, thegooddog.net, thegooddog.net. I will actually be down in New Orleans in 2 weeks, and Sean is in New Orleans a lot. Sean O'Shea, thegooddog.net. He's in New Orleans. He's the only one that I could recommend in Louisiana. And it's not that big of a state, so it's worth it, you know, going down to him. All right?
Roommate's dog is on strike two. She postures and growls. We are worried she will attack our puppy. Advice.
So what I would do is, what's your roommate doing and what's being done with that dog? So posturing and growling gets stopped pretty easily. You would correct it. You can take a bonker. You can take a bonker. You can wrap up a bonker or wrap up a towel. And if the dog postures, you would say N-O and then just toss the bonker at the dog's head. It's not going to hurt the dog. It's a cotton towel. Cotton towel. Nothing just says no. It's not going to work. You have to stop it. So Gabe, I'm not an advocate of false service dogs. Okay.
Why do you only use something, the brand you use? I don't, where's the question?
Makes sense to me. Let's see.
Why do you only use
the brand you use? I'm not quite sure what that is. If you're talking about a remote collar, if you're talking about e-collar technologies, because I like their technology and I like the brand. I like the way the stim feels. I like the results I get. E-collar brand, I like it. It works for me. I like it. It works for me. It works for my clients. That's why. But, you know, would I use a dog tra? Yes, I have. Would I use sport dog? I don't like to train on sport dog. But if an owner has a sport dog, by the time the dog is trained, yes, it would work. Tritronics, Garmin, yes, I would use those. But I just use e-collar. I love their customer service. I love all their policies. I love how quick they ship. I love the quality of them. I like the way their stim feels. Remember, different stims feel differently. Different remote collars have different stims that feel differently. Just keep that in mind. the stim is actually a computer program that can make the stim feel a certain way. Because if you put it out, on a machine that shows the waves, I don't know all the proper technical terminology on it, you can actually see like there's different remote cows that have different stims to them. Okay.
When you have good people that sell a good product too, you want to recommend them. Right. To people.
Right. Yep. She has to go to the bathroom. Good. What else? What else do we got?
I got nothing.
What about agility? Yes, do agility. Fraudulent. A lot of people put service dog vests on non-service dogs so they can get onto restaurants, stores, airplanes, and trains. So that's what fraudulent means. Fake. Fake. Or they get in, they can get into get their dog into housing. But I've seen a lot of service dogs that how do I feel about clicker training? Clicker training is great. Clicker training is great. We use clickers. But remember, all clicker is a marker. So we've just started using clickers, but we've always used markers. So clicker training is just a marker. But remember, it falls underneath the positive reinforcement category, which means it will reinforce a wanted behavior. It marks a moment in time that you want. That's what it is. So when I click, it takes a snapshot. What you just did is correct. And it will be followed up with a reward. Just like the word yes. Just you can use the word yes, you can use the word good, you can get a clicker sound on your phone. All right? You can do that. So
how long can you keep a 13-week-old puppy in place? We already answered that question.
Yeah, a 13-week-old puppy in place, you're probably looking at 5 minutes unless it fell asleep. So with 13 weeks old, at 13 week old, you're not looking for duration. You're looking just for the dog to do the command. Do I have any reference or video trainer to improve markers? I don't, but I would start going into the world of dog training to learn how to use. From stop that, Michael Ellis.
What,
from
yawning?
Yeah. That was Linda just being really, really rude and impolite.
What?
Because this is not her Periscope, so she is not a vested interest in how much that I love all of you. So get us off the show what her intention was. The question was asked prior, so do me a favor, stop being late.
Do you see my eyes wandering? Do you know what that means?
That's a thank you.
Linda has a Periscope. Heck yeah.
And there you go. I like that attitude. You out there. Having trouble fishing, rolling up on e-cal remote with one hand, is that normal? It is. Wendy, we do not encourage domestic violence on this show. Stop.
Yes,
we do not encourage domestic violence on this show.
I recommend it and I support it.
So what I would do is if you're having a hard time rolling up and you're doing close by antenna, unscrew the antenna. It'll be easier for you to do it because then your hand will be able to fit on the remote a lot easier. All right? Unscrew the antenna.
Highly reactive dog just taught e-collar, recall, and heel. Got her to avoid other dogs, but any leash tension, blank.
So what I want you to do is you might have to use a higher stim. You might have to use a higher stim, do a couple of 180s, things like that. All right? So a local trainer tried doing e-collar threats. How do you reply? You don't reply at all. You never reply. Do you know how much I get bashed? I get bashed a ton. Death threats, physical harm, threats to my children. I get called every name in the book, everything. You don't respond. You report, ban, and delete if it's on Facebook. On Facebook, ban, delete. Okay? You just ignore, absolutely ignore. 100% of the time, but you ban if it's done on Facebook. You ban them. Do you keep a copy? If you want to make a screenshot, go ahead. But it's just nonsense. I got better things to do with my time. Yep, you always ignore it because they've got more time than you. They've got no more time than you do. Trust me, right?
Where and when can I poke a dog as a manual
correction? Oh, you poke a dog sort of like right?
Or it is.
A Jimmy Jam.
Jimmy Jam.
You would, it's called a Jimmy Jam. You can do like that. Just a little bit of a Jimmy Jam. Just watch a bunch of Caesar episodes. That's it. You can also do it right there, but you can poke it like there. You can do that.
Just I like the back, the hind.
Yeah, just do a little Jimmy Jam.
Almost near the leg.
Yep.
Can't, I don't know, outside dog ignores me.
I'm a Caesar. I like Caesar. Single time. Dog ignores you, probably dog have to use your levels are too low. Those are so outside, there's a lot of distractions, so you're probably on your level, probably have to go. And no, I've never worked with him. I've been out a couple times. Is it? Yep, I've met him a couple times.
Is it okay to leave a leash play with hard to correct a dog?
No, I mean, yes, you can leave the leash on the dog all day if you are home. If you're home. I was going to say no, not when you're not home, but yes, if you are home. Absolutely. You absolutely should leave the leash on the dog. All puppies should have leashes on when they're out of their crates. Absolutely. All dogs should have leashes on them until they're trained. Only underneath your supervision. All right? Yeah, because else you're playing a game, Alan. All you're doing is Alan, or late Aline, yep. Do I respect his methods? I don't respect 100% of his methods, but what Caesar does is incredible. What he does is incredible. He's easy to bash because he's so well known, but his dog skills are incredible. His natural instinctual dog skills are great. So he's easy to bash because he's so well known. He's so well known. Trust me, there's a lot of trainers out there that are doing some really bad things to dogs. He's not one of them. And the best thing about Caesar is he has opened up the conversation that has correlated human behavior to dog behavior. Human behavior to dog behavior. Meaning you, the human, actually might be responsible for some of your dog's bad behavior, if not all of it. So, which is really cool because if you fix yourself, you can fix your dog. Okay? But that's it.
Do you walk your new boarding trains with flat collar or slip leash?
None. We use a prong collar. We use prong collars. Yeah, we don't walk dogs on slip leads. The Q&As, so Buddy and Max 1999, the Q&As are on Monday and Wednesday nights at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. This Monday, I did not have one, but they're historically on Mondays and Wednesday nights at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. What you can do is make sure you follow me on Periscope, become one of my followers, and then also turn the alert on. So you should get a little bit of a like, bing, 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 you know, like Jeff's on, do that. But historically, yeah. Yeah, some people's notification. I know, Buddy and Max 1999, you're not the only one. Maybe what I would do is this, delete Periscope off your phone and then put it back on. Put it back on. All right? What else do we got?
That's it?
Come on.
That's all I got.
Yeah, there you go. All right, what you can also do is Yo, cool. Yep, X Factor LA. Cool. Yep. So we just announced a new seminar in Australia. So we're doing two seminars in Australia. So we just announced another one in Australia, right? Do we accept clean? No, we do not. We don't.
What are your thoughts on martingale collars?
I think martingale collars are good for a trained dog. I think if you're doing a martingale remote training, you can do it. All depends on a dog, what the dog's doing. If the dog walks perfectly on the martingale, doesn't pull or responds really, really well to a little bit of leash pressure, use a martingale. Just use it. You know, just use it. If it works for you. Just remember, it's you know, all martingale cowers is a different form of pressure. How do you find a nutritionist? That's a good question. I actually don't know, but Wendy Volhard, V-O-L-H-A-R-D, remind me, I gotta buy more food. Wendy Volhard, she's been doing this for 30 or 35 years. What I would do is I would look into her stuff. Hi, Jeff and Linda. Jeff, me in Chicago. We would love to do one in the Chicago area. What you want to do is you want to email my assistant, Lauren, L-A-U-R-E-N, Lauren at my company name, which is Solid Canine Training. If you go to RV Dog Trainer, rvdogtrainer.com, there's actually an application you can fill out to host one, to apply to host one. Yep. Apply to host one. All right. What food do you use personally? I would use Fromm for some of our dogs, and I use Volhard for some of my dogs. Okay.
Have multiple dogs pulling a sled, but one snaps at another. Should I use a muzzle?
Or just stop the snapping. Or stop the snapping. So what you can do is you could use a muzzle, but I'd be worried about the dogs being able to breathe and pant properly if it's pulling a sled. So I would just use a muzzle. And I'm sorry, I would just correct the dog, just say, knock it off. If you got a sled, you should have a dressage whip. And what I would do is I'd snap the dog on the ass. Absolutely a basket muzzle, if you're gonna use one. Yeah, a dog's pulling a sled needs to breathe. It needs to pant. It needs to pant and breathe. It's working really hard. It's working really, really hard.
Thanks, Sarah Baker. That's what I was gonna say, yep. Too. Trainer in Georgia.
Yep. Oh, there's also, there's another person in Georgia. Shoot. I forgot her name.
Those one I missed.
Our seminars for owners and dogs, or RV Dog Trainer. RV Dog Trainer is geared for dog owners, but some dog trainers go there. Train the Trainers is, no, Jeremy Majors is actually up in Wisconsin. He was down in Georgia to visit Josh. And that's Argos Dog Works. Josh Donahue. Look up Josh Donahue.
Do you know any good trainers in Montreal?
Montreal, I would look up, I don't know the name of these people's company. Shoot. What's his name? Sarah, who's up in Montreal? With him and his girlfriend are on Dogtow. Thank you. Thank you. Dogtow. Thank you. I'm trying to think. Yep. Do we have an Ohio spot yet? Not yet. Not yet. Dominic, thank you, Dominic. Good trainers in New Jersey. What I would do, let's see, a good trainer in New Jersey. I would look up, I can't remember names right now. Stacy, and what I would do is, Blake is, you can do, depends on how close you are to New York. Blake is in Manhattan. You can do that. Scary Stacy Garabix, G-A-R-A-B-I-C-S, which it's PET, Pure Energy Training, maybe. Pure Energy Training.
What about, yeah. Richmond, Virginia?
Richmond, Virginia. I don't know. Your canine police officer brought home a new dog. We'll be working soon with. I know. I saw that. Yeah, Ryan got a new dog. So Ryan got a new dog, and Eric is going to be doing the training. I know, I saw that. I'm in Providence, Rhode Island. That is Boston. So Providence, Rhode Island is. You might as well do it. I'm in Providence, Rhode Island. I'm 40 minutes away. So I just drove. I drove longer to get here tonight from where my seminar is to get back to this house. No, it's not for seminar purposes. It is for seminar purpose. It is.
So close.
So we're really close. So we're local. We have one coming up in March. We've got a March seminar in Providence, Rhode Island. All right, everybody, it's 10 o'clock. Linda's gonna probably put a kid to bed. I'll do a couple more things.
Bye, guys. I'm gonna bounce. Yo.
Yeah, you can get, absolutely, your clients can have free time. Absolutely, your clients can have free time. Yep. Absolutely. Of course. playtime. Sure. Yep. 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 Definitely. Okay, everybody, go to solidcaninetraining.com, solidcaninetraining.com. And then also, little character on the corner, share this on Facebook, share this on Twitter, share this on Periscope. Join me on Periscope. Sign up in my Periscope family. Got a lot of great stuff that we're doing. Thanks, Raquel. I love you. And then don't forget to go to rvdogtrainer.com. We just booked another seminar in Cairns, Australia. Now I get to buy my ticket to fly over there, and I get to book my Airbnb, which is going to be exciting. I'm going to stay in someone's apartment over there or house. And what else? I've got a seminar coming up in New Orleans in 2 weeks, and I've got a seminar back in Rhode Island in March, and then I go over to Australia for 12 days, and then I'm going to be up in Canada. Philadelphia is in August, so if you've not bought your tickets, buy your tickets, because all these seminars are going to sell out. Yeah. One Australian seminar already sold out. That's where I'm staying an extra week and doing another one. Yeah. Philadelphia is in August. I don't know the dates. Go to rvdogtrainer.com, rvdogtrainer.com. Oh, good. Yeah, the interviews were fun. What dates will you be in Rhode Island? Well, I live in Rhode Island. So I'll be back in Rhode Island. That's where my training center is. Let's see. I'll be back there on the 28th of February, I believe. And then I'll be there on and off for, my titles are too long. Yeah. Ah, shoot. You can still tweet it. You can still share on Twitter afterwards, I think. You can also shorten them. So Sarah, shorten it. Shorten my titles. Shorten my titles. Yeah. Try to keep them less than 3 lines. All right. Pug gets on the couch and digs at it. Don't let the dog get on the couch. Yeah, Alan, if you haven't signed up for Providence, that's where you want to do that. Right. All right, Sarah, April, good. You're going to love it. It's going to be a lot of fun. All right, everybody, I've got to go because Lynn has to do her Periscope. I've got a bunch of social media to do. And old pug, bonker, or just have a leash on the dog. Bonker will work fine, pet convincer, anything, right? Madly in love with all of you. I feel blessed and honored that I can share this information with you. You're all fantastic, and I really care about you a lot, right? Good, good. All right, madly in love with all of you. Bye-bye. Oh, good. The whole family will be there. That'll be fun. So I'm going to have to shorten my freaking – I'm just going to call it dog training Q&A from now on then.